Thank you. Thank you. What?
Thank you.
or shy? Fluttershy.
I have power over people, though they may appear complex. For me, thank you.
My viewers completely ruined RimWorld. I got a mod that puts them in the game.
Stop smiling, dude. Shut up.
Any living creature is now named after somebody in chat, and it keeps track of their message history.
Hey, yo. You guys want to kill this rooster? No!
I also got a mod that lets viewers buy items or events that are spawned in-game, like a tornado. The list of spawnable things is absolutely massive, so naturally it just devolved into chaos immediately.
What? Who ordered like a million monkeys, dude? Ooh, says the monkey. Please buy bananas. Dude, I'm telling you, chat, you keep sending monkeys like this, they're gonna die. They're gonna eat all my food. There's too many monkeys, dude. That monkey's last words, he said, "Together we defeat God," and then he just got blown to shit by a grenade.
Okay, I'm releasing the floodgates, chat. Everybody get your commands ready.
Oh my God.
Oh Jesus, how long should I do it for? I don't know. Oh my God, okay. I think the bot broke. I think you guys went so quick that the bot broke. Maybe everyone, oh my god. Multiple people called in Man in Black, Rez. What? Dude, this f***ing corgi is out here by Human Leather 13. What are you doing? Who are you? Gameplay mate. Dude, who is this? Salvador? Why are there 100 corgis? Colonel Jack? Tim the Tumbleweed? Wait, who f***ing summoned corgis? Or what kind of dogs are these? These are Yorkshire Terriers, aren't they? Tornado? We got visitors. Oh look, it's Blazestone and Zawan 9 and Yclept. Hey guys, welcome to our beautiful colony. You guys are gonna love.
Purple guy. Hello, lovely people. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I am joined by the lovely secular spirit, and we are going to be talking a little bit about Islam, how we discuss Islam, the problems with Islam, critique versus Islamophobia. It's going to be super, super interesting. Secular, would you like to just introduce us briefly to who you are?
Yes, definitely. I should also first say thank you so much for having me on here. I really appreciate it. And I've been a fan of your channel for a very long time. And I'm so glad that you responded when I reached out. And yeah, so my channel is called Secular Spirit. You can find me on YouTube, Twitter, Instagram. And I focus mainly on Islam, but for the most part, it's about religion and how religious ideas harm us and how we can potentially do better with a more humanist secular perspective. And yeah, I've been doing the channel for a year and I come from an ex-Muslim background, and Secular Spirit is not my name, not my birth name. And I use a fake name for the channel as well, Alim, which is spelled A-L-E-E-M. And I'll get into why I use a fake name later on in our discussion. So yeah, that's my intro right there.
Fabulous. And thank you so much for reaching out and for joining me. This is definitely the area where I am nowhere near the expert. You're the expert in this situation.
Well, I did notice one of the reasons I reached out to you is because I noticed that you talked a lot about Christianity and religion in general, but I noticed that you hadn't really touched the subject of Islam. So I was also reaching out to kind of ask, is there a reason for that? And I guess we'll get into that a little bit too.
Shall we start with a little bit about your background, why you kind of do your channel, and then we can talk about why I haven't been talking about Islam.
Yeah. I'll give you the long story short version. You can find the full, long, boring 2-hour version on my channel.
Interesting and exciting, cool version.
Yeah, thank you. I need help with the self-promotion for sure. So I was born in the Middle East, in Dubai, United Arab Emirates. I come from a Palestinian background. And so I was born and raised Muslim. And if you might not be familiar with Islam, I think I can give you a little bit of an introduction too. You think that's a good idea, Emma?
Yeah, that would be wonderful. Okay. I think most of us, certainly on my channel, have a very Christian background or Christian-centric kind of background.
Well, I can kind of tell you how Islam was taught to me and how it was presented in relation to the other major religions. So growing up in the Middle East, most people are Muslim, especially in the country where I was in, the UAE. And I was a Sunni Muslim. And when I was being taught about Islam in school, most of my education in Islam came in school. So the way the story goes is that Islam is the final message of the one true God. So this is the same God, actually, that Christians believe in, that the Jewish people believe in. And what happened was when the Jews and the Christians kind of just started spreading and teaching their religion, the true message of God was changed, adulterated. And twisted to benefit the human beings who, let's say, rewrote the Bible. So God can stand by and watch. So he sent one final prophet, one final messenger, who is Muhammad. And Muhammad was in modern-day Saudi Arabia, 7th